High-performance computing is when we have lots of resources available, lots of processing memory, high-speed bandwidth for transferring data. You can run any form of jobs over there, find out what the weather could be for the after 10 days, find out how molecules interact between each other, find out how images can be processed, or maybe look at or develop a model for self-driving cars. So there's a lot of data, and it's not feasible for our normal laptops or desktops or to run that kind of an analysis. So that's where the high-performance computing makes things more accessible.
It opens up a lot of doors to things that I could never do on my laptop. I even still find myself often writing code thinking, oh, there's no way this is ever gonna run because it's gonna take way too many resources. Go to a supercomputer and actually compute a whole bunch of test cases and get a whole bunch of results. You can get all these, you can plot out the results of what your project is, and you can sort of see what you're doing a lot better.
Using the Bose supercomputer alone, we're able to take a process that might have taken 2 weeks and maybe would have been unable to do at all, and we're able to trim it down to 2 hours.
The way that we access the supercomputer is through an internet conversation. It's an actual physical device in the Chippewa Valley Technical College. And so we send our code and our data off to that site. It does the running. It's an actual physical machine there, and it sends it back to us.
When you're doing research, it's very difficult to think about what else we can do. But by having just at least one more option of let's try this, it unlocks so much more insight. It unlocks a lot more observations that you might not have found because it would have taken you so long to compute.
Using HPCs in their research projects for a student, it not only opens up that research opportunity, learning that new skill set, exposure, it also opens up research collaborations to other departments as well.
We can do 3D hydrologic modeling, which is the ability then to predict floods and velocities of water at a much greater accuracy than ever before, which obviously is a huge part of understanding our own Chippewa River that's in our backyard.
We have collaboration with Mayo Clinic where we have students working on detecting pancreas from CT scans. We have students who are working on security and using deep learning for enhancing security with mouse motions. There have been research done at UW-Eau Claire where we have tried to look at how COVID-19 is being affected by the oxidative stress of our bodies. Those kinds of research wouldn't have been possible without the resources that we have in terms of high-performance computing.
Research has really prepared me for just kind of being an independent learner, and I feel like that helps you really adapt to current challenges.
So I feel like I've been getting, you know, kind of bits and pieces of everything possible to make me successful in wherever I end up.
To even get the opportunity to have that Eau Claire, let alone use it, is really special because it's a resource that all students can access. My resume and the job interviews, it was incredibly powerful to say, like, I've been hands-on on a high-performance computer, and I've been able to use that and explain that how that has played into my research and some of the things that have come out of that.
It provides students with something that they're not going to be able to get at most universities in this area.
Most of the time, those high-performance computing resources are used for graduate study, graduate education, graduate research. Here, we are, all the students who are using it are undergraduate students. So it's amazing to see that kind of tool which our undergraduate students are using.